Hello guys, you're welcome back to my channel again, and in this video I'll be showing you guys how to go about doing a dispersion effect using Photoshop. If you are just coming across my channel for the first time, you are welcome, and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button down there and also turn on the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I drop another wonderful tutorial video. Without any further delay, let's dive into the tutorial. Yeah, so we're going to create a new document entirely. Going to just fit in. Then this is the image we're going to be using. This image. Yeah, so I'm going to set. Yeah. Then I'm going to add a solid color to my background, like a gray background color like that. Then after doing that, we'll go to filter, then select on liquify, wait for Photoshop to open it. Yeah, so this is the liquify interface. Then we'll set the size to 150, the density to 32, the period to 100. Then we'll select on the liquify brush. Then we're going to use the brush to point to the direction where you want the dispersion effect to take place, like how I'm doing it now. So I want the dispersion effect to come from the left hand side. So I'm using the brush to liquefy it, the image, just like this. You have to be very patient when you are doing this. You don't have to rush. So we're done. Then we'll click on OK. Don't be afraid. Then we add a layer mask to it. We invert it by pressing on our keyboard Ctrl I. Then we select our brush tool. We'll go under the brush panel, and then we'll click on the special brush, special effect brush, and then we'll select the first brush there. Then we set the size of the brush to 280, then we'll start to brush. You can see the dispersion effect is already taking place already from the left hand side. Yeah, so we're going to brush it just like this, brush it until you are satisfied with the dispersion effect on the image. Yeah, so that's it on how to do a dispersion effects using Photoshop. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button down there, and also turn on the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I drop another tutorial. See you in my next tutorial. Bye for now.